Guys, I'm well, I think it's the first blog of the year. I'm like, we're in, what, May? Sorry it's been so long, I've had loads going on lately. A lot going on at home, loads of work life. Just general day-to-day life, so fishing just got pushed to the back edge. I mean, I have been on fishing, whether you've kept up to date on the Facebook page and whatnot. On my Instagram, obviously my Instagram's been going off the chain lately, so. But I'm on a Wambi Club late today, so I'm not gonna. I will show a bit of the lake, but I'm not gonna show it all. I'm not gonna name where it is, and obviously if you watch the blogs in the past, then you will know what club I'm on. I've just came down for the day. I was gonna do the night, but I've got my kids tonight, so I can't really do the night, unfortunately. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm just down for the day. I've just got me sawn offs. Just come down. I'll go through the kit later on, but basically it's just. What I normally do with my other lakes is just go down with the short multi rig, semi-stiff braid, and little pink pop-ups, light scattering and boilers over the top. One's down a margin, one's in like a big open area, like it's like troughs off, but it has been really hot lately, so I'm thinking they might be on the top, so I've got some surface gear, but I'm not really too clued up whether they allow surface fishing in here at the moment. But we'll give it a go. But I know there's a special fish in here, there's like a nice size fish in here, it's like a 30 pound fish, which I didn't know about until the other day, until I was speaking to a lad. And one of the other anglers down at the bank has just confirmed it. And there's one matchman on here, so doing a little bit like fishing for the road and that, and there's another one just over there, a carper, by the look of things, he's just setting up his buzz bars now. I'm just basically going to watch see where these are fishing to, because obviously this is a new water for me. I'm fishing where I've seen fish moving, but there's a lot of rudd in here, and I think they're starting to spawn. I'm just hoping if the carp starts spawning, I'll just pack up my gear and go, because I'm not fishing for spawning fish. There's not really else to report. It's a lovely lake, it really is. It's stunning. It's probably the closest one to me, to be fair. I mean, it's still about 45 minutes away from my house, but it's nice. I need to start fishing these places more often, but I'm literally, this is midweek. The size of them things. Like bombers then, geese. I'm fishing midweek. I've took a week off work because I've been working in Denby and Wales, so it's been chaotic. It's only meant to be there a week, but I've been there. This would have been a 6 week down there. But the wildlife down here is fantastic as well. I mean, there's that amount of bird life down here. But, okay, well, until something, something carpy happens, then I'll get back to you.
Well, something carpy has just happened. What can you say? I've been in the swim probably about half an hour. Just sitting there chilling. Taking a couple of carpy shots on the camera. Unless it wants to behave itself. A real nice, big plated linear. Say probably about 12 pounds. Maybe touching 15. I'll weigh it in a bit when I do the stills. But didn't really put up that much of a fight, to be fair. Like, I mean, it was only fishing about 6 or 7 yards out, or down the left-hand side of the margins. Inline lead, little pink CC more dirty green pop-up. But what a way to start off my club water account. Absolutely buzzing with this. So I'm going to take a couple of stills and get it back, see if I can get another one. Well, that was a bit of a turn on for the books. Now, what I thought was about 12, maybe 15 pounds, just weighed it then. Actually went 17.3, so
if you've done my maths right, it's 17-3 because I've got obviously got the duck things with the sling and that, but yeah, I can't believe that. Like, I mean, should I look back on photos then, it does look every bit of it, but that's what a way to start it. What a way to start my account on here. So yeah, started the blog out, blog with the fish, thank God for that. But over the moon, so basically what that was, it was probably about a 6-inch multi-rig on semi-stiff. So with a 10 milli CC Model Dairy Supreme pop up. So what was the hook? Well, obviously what the hook was, it was a Viper Tackle, size 6 wide gate, SP, barbless again. The hooks are really sharp. I mean, to be honest, I think that was the rig that I caught the 23.5 pounds common on last week. So, which I didn't film, wasn't on. Yeah, obviously that sneaky little lake that I've got, the Secret Garden, as everyone is now starting to ask where it is. Now again, I'm not going to tell anyone where the Secret Garden is. If you know, you know. But it's one of them sort of venues where you need to know, like the farmer, to do anything there. So it's not the easiest of lakes either. You know, people go down there and they think there's no carp in there. There is. There's clearly some very nice carp in there. If you keep an eye on my social media accounts, like the Facebook Liverpool Carpers page and Liverpool Carpers Instagram page, then you'll see the fish that I've got that I've had out of there. I'm two left to get out of there, and then one of them is extremely tricky. It's a ghostie, which came out last week, believe it or not. So to a lad from Scouse Blanks now, well done to him for that, because that's a cracking fish. Decent photographs as well, which is the main thing. Now, while we're on the subject of tackle as well, now, sorry, there's a little knock on the rod. Team Viper are taking more people on. Like, I mean, I think we just had our first two females in there as well, so if there's any more females that they want to get onto a decent tackle company, that's still very new, but it's going places, then just go for it. It's just email Chris, or like message them, add them on Facebook, do whatever, just get on there. It's a decent company. We're constantly doing socials. I mean, we've got the Mennington social coming up soon, which is going to be a really good one to do. It's going to be a vlog, it's going to be a long blog, but I might do it into two or three parts maybe. I have had a few messages on my own Facebook about where Mark is, and you know, is he fishing? Yeah, Mark is still fishing. He's still here. The name has been changed from Liverpool Carpers to Liverpool Carpers for a reason. He is obviously a part of me, part of the team. Keep on hearing me a little alarm going all the way. I think it's a bird next to me chair. Now, yeah, I'm going to see if I can get out a little bit more often, but for now, I'm over the moon with that fish. Catch you in a bit. Let's go through a couple of tactics then. Basically, me and Mark get a lot of messages asking about what rigs to use, like how to approach a certain water. And well, basically, me and Mark, we only ever really use one rig, you know, one, maybe two rigs, and basically it consists of a multi-rig. So I don't know whether you can be able to see that or not, but basically that's like a 6-inch rig. That this is like a semi-stiff material, so I use the stuff from your Fox or Corder, to be fair, with a blob of putty on the knot, because obviously there's just two loops on each end. And this has got, just for the sake of the video, it's got a curve shank on it. Now, instead of mounting it to bait floss and tying it through, I have a ring swivel, a bait screw with a ring on it. I slide down the D. That's just easy to unscrew and screw on the a pop up. No, it's much easier. Now I prefer to use like a 14 miller if I can. If I can get away with it. Which is the CC more stuff. Now I tie like a figure of eight on the back end of this, simply because I do a bigger one, because I loop it through. That's pretty much what me and Mark use mainly. Mark's even been testing out the multi-rig in a stiff material in a solid bag. Now that's unheard of, but he's using it like a really small one, and he went to a local lake the other day and he said he's done really well on it, which is something I never thought I'd see, like a stiff rig in a solid bag. But that's mainly what me and Mark try and do, is just we approach waters the same way we would any water, like our local. I mean, the local secret garden, you know, it's not an easy lake. It's a very snaggy water. If you don't know where to fish, you're not gonna know where to fight. They don't show themselves that often. I've only ever seen like 2 or 3 shows in there in the 6 years I've fished there. 5 years that I've fished there, nearly 6. But it's like this water today. I've literally just came, spoke to one angler. He gave us a pointer on where lads like fish for carp fish. And then I came down this end, where I had been down here once before, but it was frozen, so I had to go to a different lake. I can't remember like what the lake was called. But I just fished how I normally fish, same rigs, everything. Lead setups, I mean, I've got an inline on one lead, on one rod at the moment, just to test it out. Because I used to fish an awful lot with inlines. I had a load of success with them as well. Caught some of my nicest fish with inlines as well. This one's only just cast just down the bank, about a foot off the reeds. I mean, you can cast tighter reeds, you really can, but in here, I've noticed there's new shoots coming through, so I just came a little bit off. Just to be on the safe side, I'm not going to be wrapped around, or my line's going to be wrapped around anything. But on my right hand rod, I'm just casting over to the far side reeds, because I haven't seen anything knocking, but the sun is literally hitting them. So I'm assuming that it's going to be, when I put me on the water, really warm the edge, so, you know, there's going to be fish around there cruising at least, because it's only about a foot or 2 foot deep. And I have just seen a carp, I'd say about 15 pounds, just cruising there. I mean, it wasn't interested in anything, flicking bait at it, she wasn't interested, but it was going through. But I'm baiting up a place on my right hand side now as well. It's on like a point, baiting that part up consistently, just crushing up boilies and throwing them out, a couple of whole boilies, a couple of half boilies. Just going to see if that'll produce. I mean, I'm going to give it another hour on the far spot, and then big bird flying over, and then go from there, like put it on that spot there, see, just margin fishing. Because that's all I ever really do, is I only really ever margin fish. Mark's the same. He does like to put a bit of bait down. Mark, he does like to do that, but I'm not sort of angler. I have little patches, like I set little traps here and everywhere. I like stalking more than anything, to be fair. Well, it is tenting in here to give it like a zig or go today, but I'm not sure whether you can use them or not. I'll have to read the rule book. I'm gonna have to, but I know what I'm using is safe and I know what I'm using is allowed for you, but even still. But I made up, caught that fish this morning. Made up. I think I'd have a little check in. I've been here so far. Caught a tench. Lost a tench. Had a snooze in the sun. Realised I've got an absolute shed load of, nearly said another word then, an absolute shed load of coursework that I haven't even done yet. And needs being by tomorrow. So definitely have to cut the session a little bit shorter, because I say I've got to go pick the kids up anyway. So I'm going to try and get back down here, hopefully by, say, tomorrow night for the night maybe. So that could be another little instalment of, obviously, of this club league, or club waters, should I say. Well, say nothing else has really happened. I've had a couple of liners and obviously just those tench. I'm not going to film a tench, I'm not going to take a photo of it unless it was an absolute monster, but they weren't. They were only about £3 if that. But there's fish on the surface here, so I'm going to have to check whether I can search fish for them or not, like for future reference really. But apart from that, that's pretty much everything that's going on really. It's only going to be a short vlog, not going to be a long one by any stretch, but get myself back into the swing of it with the filming. But we will get there, and hopefully I can maybe bag another one before I go. But I've only got an hour or two before, well, an hour and a half before I've got to go, so let's fingers crossed, eh, tightly crossed. Right, well, as you can see, I'm no longer fishing. I came home, camera died unfortunately, so I was taking too many carpy shots. So I had to come home and get this little one and a little brother from nature, didn't I? But yeah, no more happened, nothing else occurred. Just the usual liners and that was, and then I could have stayed for a bit longer, but I had to miss the traffic to come home and get these. So that's the end of that really, but yeah, no long vlog by any stretch, but this is it. So what have you got to say, Dave? Like, subscribe. and share.
Like, subscribe and share.
Yeah, so don't forget to like, subscribe and share. So, until next time, see you later.